thank you very much. I appreciate you coming over tonight and giving up time with your family and your friends and take the abuse I'm about to give you.
I'm going to take my little trip today. We're going to go on a trip to a place called the Next Economy. It's not a very long trip. It's a pretty short trip. It begins in 2006 and it ends in 2026. So it's a very short trip, but unfortunately, during this period, we're in for a time where the impact upon a North American business is really going to become, or really will be, unprecedented. So you'll have to bear with me as we go through it. Some of this is a little heavy. If you want a copy of it at the end of it, just give me your card and I'll get a copy to you. We'll see whether you're interested in pursuing it. Along the way, what we're going to do is talk about where the economy is going. There's a lot of people who have different opinions about it. I'm going to give you a hypothesis that says that a good marketing person is better qualified to tell you where the economy is going than any of the analysts that you now deal with and listen to, or any of the folks you see on CNN. That doesn't have to be me. It could be any marketing person. When we finally talk about the next economy, we'll talk about the characteristics and what kind of place it's going to be and how it's going to operate, what you're going to have to do to change, because there's some huge changes coming. We're going to talk about the inevitability of whether this is really going to happen. I mean, you know, 2 weeks ago, there was a recession. A week ago, there was no recession. Next week, we're going to go back and we're going to have another recession. And the week after, we won't have a recession. So, you know, if we can't figure out where we are now, how can anybody stand up in front of you and tell you where we're going to go? You'll have to make that judgment on your own. And finally, assuming I can convince you that this is really going to happen, you're going to have to take a little bit of time to think about what it means to you, because we are not talking about small changes to your life. Those of you in marketing are some serious issues ahead of you, and you're going to have to make some serious changes. So, where are we going? If there's one word that talks about where we are right now, it's confusion. And I just want you to understand my perspective on confusion and why I think it's happening, and then you can toss it out or accept it based on your own experience. The reason we have confusion is we have two very respected groups of people out there giving us totally different pieces of information, measuring supposedly the same environment. We have the analysts and the financial economists who are sitting there telling us things and representing Wall Street's vision of what's going on. And then we have marketers who don't particularly have a strong venue, by the way, who are trying to tell you what's going on Main Street. And there's a disconnect between what's happening on Wall Street and what's happening on Main Street. And I thought we should explore a little bit of this disconnect, because it'll help you, let's say it'll help you accept some of the things I'm going to ask you to accept in a few minutes from now. Wall Street believes that there's lower profits and lower revenue expectations out there, and that basically things are just going to be tough for the foreseeable future. But Main Street folks, the marketing group, knows that there's still a very, very high degree of consumer confidence. You can see that, you know, even after 9/11, We didn't sink down below the 80s, and we're moving our way up progressively back to where we were. We never were back at the 80 and 90, 1980, 1990 numbers of 64, 65. That never happened. So there's still some very, very strong confidence in the marketplace that somehow we're not getting back from Wall Street. Wall Street believes that if you want to understand success, you have to measure it by what's happening on the Dow and what's happening on the S&P. But that's not what marketers are finding out. Marketers found out a long time ago, and you folks probably know this, that there's 90% of all corporations in America have less than 20 people in them. That small business is the background of this country. It's the backbone of this country. And that 50% of the private sector output is generated from small business, and 66% of all the new jobs are coming from the small business sector, and there is no venue for small business to talk. We don't hear a word about any of this. So they're all under the radar screen, and all we hear about is what the folks who are measuring the large corporations in America are telling us. What they say to us is that the reference leaders are CEOs and CFOs of America's largest corporations, and they further tell us that those experts happen to be old, white, and male. What the marketers have found out is that 66% of all GDP is driven by consumer goods, as you probably know, goods and services. And you know what? Mom is the CFO of America and the CEO of America, because mom either directly buys or influences directly 77% of the 66% that drives the entire economy. And all of it is under the radar screen. We don't see any of it. Wall Street believes that the tech meltdown has devastated the dot-com community and its dot-bomb time, and the thing is in disarray and it's a total mess. It's just not what marketers are finding out. Small specialty sites are just booming. They're just booming. They can't figure out what's going on out there. We're running a number now. It looks like we will run $35 billion in e-commerce last year. I mean, that's exactly where we projected it would be. I mean, we were sitting around 3 years ago saying, boy, if we could get $35 billion or $33 billion in 2001, then we can hit $50 billion in 2002. And they can't figure out where the sales are coming from. But every small specialty site you know of, every retailer that has a little corner store that went online, all those guys, those hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people, have little websites with great productivity gains. They're getting 25, 30% sales increases, and they have no infrastructure cost at all. They're getting some small little web guy locally to do it, or they're tagging onto a neighborhood site, and they're all doing well. You know, I have a couple of passions in my life. One of them is cars, another one's classical guitar. There are sites for me. I could spend all day there buying anything I wanted to buy about anything I wanted to learn about guitar making. I mean, everybody who has a passion about something can find a place to buy it, and it's all under the radar screen. So when they tell you, you know, listen to CNN, FN, and Bloomberg, and CNBC, because those folks are affecting market performance. But we know, the marketing folks know, 54% of America now owns stock, and we have the Nielsen's for those programs. They're less than half a point. So there's a huge disconnect again. The problem is that we're dealing with the symptoms and we're not really dealing with the inherent issues. And we're listening to a bunch of people who are really trying to give us some insight as to what's going on, but they don't have the expertise to understand where they have to look and what to do about where they have to look to be able to translate that for us, and they ignore it completely.